to the Midday Live Show. Go on, meet the crew. You know what we just came to do. No telling who be coming through.
Jazza, Fritz, and Steve, who styles gotta fit the mood. It did been a while, they left the milk. I got us DJ
who. DJ who? DJ Spoil Milk on the ones and twos. Catch the show, watch it, be on 12 and noon. Ain't nothing like them other shows. They checking for your podcast. All hard, just broadcast. Go stream it live on YouTube.
Brand new, everything about them got a bag too. Had to, cause now they see the stars when they pass through. Bad news, if you ain't up on this, you can't slide through. Especially when they fine dining, shining, but the time winding.
Hey, 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 welcome back. It's the Midday Live Show, season 3, episode 17. I think this is
17.
38. I don't know. I'm just
I see what you did there. Fetty Wap. Yeah.
Okay. I like that.
Well, you're 38, right?
So, yeah. Yeah.
Right?
You know this.
He gets it.
You get it.
He
gets it.
It was a double joke. You see what I did there?
I did.
There. That was nice.
Strong.
Very nice.
But are we Remy or are we tequila, guys? Let's be honest.
We're tequila.
We're tequila.
Mm-hmm.
It aligns with our brand.
Exactly. So I'm Jazz, aka Jazzer Fierce, aka the fiercest of them all. And to my left,
it's your boy Steve Styles, the master podcaster, of course, live at iHeartRadio Chicago. Lovely city, beautiful city, the best city. To the head of the table, we got
the nastiest DJ in Chicago, DJ Spoiled Milk.
Yes, what's that smell?
I'm here every Friday. I love being in studio with you guys. It's the energy for me. You know, it starts my weekend off right.
Good.
No matter how much traffic or how many car accidents, I'm here, baby. I'm here.
You made it. That's what matters. That's what matters. And it's all about the energy in the room, the energy of the people that are here.
Yeah.
And we have somebody very, very special in studio today.
Uh-oh.
So let me tell y'all a little something. Yeah. Give me a drum roll. National radio personality.
Ooh,
okay.
National.
Okay. But what is really important right here in Chicago, 103.5 KISS FM, Ooh, Chicago, afternoons, on. Every afternoon. 3 to 7 p.m. He goes by the name of Brady. It's Brady on the Midday Live Show.
Big round of applause. Big round of applause.
You guys have such cool names, like monikers. I need one. I'm just Brady. I need
Brady's
to have
awesome.
One.
Like,
Brady's awesome.
Like Brady. I mean, Brady Broski's good.
That's cool.
The main Broski. Mm-hmm.
But how many people can go by just one name? Like one Cher.
Not many.
You know?
Prince, Cher, Beyonce.
Brady, Beyonce.
Let's keep it.
There you go.
Let's keep it simple.
You're in a great
clean.
Company. Let's great company.
Clean. Thank you guys for having me. This is so fun.
Thank
I love
you.
What you. I love what you guys have done.
Yeah, yeah.
This is insane.
Stop. We're not cutting onions yet. We're not there.
Okay.
We're not there.
I'm sure we could inform the viewers if you're watching us. We just want to let you guys know we do have some camera people in the audience right now. So if you see some people in the background shifting between scenes, just know that they're collecting content.
Yeah, they're really getting in my earwax.
Oh.
I should have used a Q-tip at one point today,
okay.
But I didn't. But you feel free, whatever.
Okay.
Keep it real.
Right. Yeah, that's what we do.
Yeah,
that's what we do. That's what
we do.
So starting off with the real Brady, please take us back to the very beginning of your journey in radio and then just kind of take us through the story of how you got to now in 2024.
My girl Jazz, I'm so proud of you guys. First of all, before
Thank
I get
you.
Into any of that, I do want to give you guys your flowers, right?
Oh,
because I know I've seen you all, we've worked together for years now, and this is amazing. I am so like honored to be on the show and for you guys to have done this like yourself. You've all hustled to get to this point. You built it brick by brick. You've got stickers, banners.
Yeah.
You've got your own logo. It's just, it's very impressive. And I just want to say, like, I'm happy for you guys and, you know, keep crushing it. You're doing something that nobody else is doing. You have a vision.
Yes.
And you went with it and you rolled with it and you should be all be proud of yourself. So
Thank
before
you.
I get
Thank
into my
you.
Story, I just want to give you guys your
Thank
flowers.
You.
Okay.
Appreciate that.
Yeah,
Thank
of course.
You so much.
Of course.
It's been great.
Now let's talk about me.
Yes.
So you want my story. So is it cool if I go like from now till backwards?
Love
Can
that.
I do that?
Yes.
Sure,
switch
sure,
it up.
Sure.
Yeah, let's go. Let's do that. So obviously I'm here in Chicago.
Yeah.
I've been here for 10 years on 103.5 KISS FM, Chicago's number one music station.
Come on.
I'm also on several markets across the country with iHeartRadio, St. Louis, New Haven, afternoons there. I have weekend shows in Dallas. There's just a bunch of markets.
Great.
I also have, a lot of people don't know this, this is really fun and near and dear to my heart. It's a nightly 80s show.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a nightly 80s show on iHeartRadio because I'm an 80s baby.
Yeah.
So I go back to like when I was like a little kid playing with, you know, toys and action figures and I talk about like that kind of thing.
Yeah.
And that's the audience that I want to bring in.
Get out.
Play 80s music.
I
so
love that.
That's nice.
If you're upper end watching this, check out the 80s show. That's weeknights.
So if you played with Ghostbusters and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles,
come.
You may.
Let's go.
Come in.
We discussed these things, these very important things. So prior to my experience here in Chicago, which, by the way, I'm living my dream job. 100%. Like, I walk in, I don't know how you guys feel when you get off that elevator and you're
exhilarating.
Like,
amazing.
It is. It's yeah. like,
what's you see that red room too? Mm-hmm.
You see the red room. Yeah. You see the skyline.
Yeah.
You
see the gumball machine.
The gumball machine for the winning trips. Not me, right?
Hot nacho cheese. That's it for me.
We got a boss that buys us nacho cheese. It's just, it's amazing coming to work.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to do this. And the fact that I get, like, when I was a kid, I'd be like, I'd do this for free.
Yeah.
I get paid. You get I have paid. A career in something I always wanted to do.
Yeah.
So I'm very blessed to be in, you know, this big market of Chicago. And this is home now. I've been here for 10 years, like I said. Met some lifelong friends, met my wife here. And it's the career's taken off since I've been here. So that's Chicago in a nutshell.
Mm-hmm.
Prior to here, I did mornings in Hartford, Connecticut. I'm a New England guy, born and raised. So I did mornings there for about 4 years. Then I got the call. Hartford's like the, you know, it's not the little leagues. Trust me, it's a big city.
Yeah.
But I got the call from Chicago, and I was like, "Mom, bye." Like, "Mom,
time to go.
I'll see you in a couple of years," and then never came back. So I did mornings in Hartford, which was a blast. I had a great morning show crew. Learned a lot from them, but also loved coming here and not having to wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning. So that was a blessing.
That's real.
You guys
real.
Know. You guys
we know. We know.
We've all waken up like events. Mm-hmm. You know. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. And then prior to that, I did like a night gig in New Haven, which is funny because now I'm on afternoons on that very station. That kind of that was my first iHeart station.
Look at that.
KC101. So now I'm on afternoons on the station that iHeart first hired me for. So kind of a little full circle.
Right?
Yeah.
Wow.
Before that, I did a small gig in Connecticut as well. And then before that, and this is like kind of old school radio, I moved to the middle of nowhere to take a job making like peanuts in a market that was like 175. And I just took a gamble, bet on myself, knew I was not gonna make any money, knew I had to hustle, knew I had to work like three different jobs just to pay rent, but I did it. And I feel like that's part of that. That's one of the reasons why I am where I am today is because like, I didn't want to do that forever. I wanted to continue to grow. I wanted to be like with gumball machines and skylines and all this stuff. But to do that stuff brought me to where I'm at now. So that's kind of my radio journey professionally.
Yeah.
I had a little college radio show that was a joke. It was just me and like my roommate. And we just basically like just tried to get like girls that we wanted to like hang out with to listen. But that didn't work because we all sucked. But yeah, that's kind of my radio career from mid, late 2000s till now. So 2024. So
it's been a journey.
Yeah,
it has. And you know what's crazy is like nowadays the kids nowadays it's interesting, like there's not a lot of people that have to like go from market to market in radio because of technology, number one. Our medium is shrinking, so there's not as many opportunities as there used to be. But like back in the day, like you would be like, I will move to the middle of
nowhere,
Nebraska.
Right. Oh,
I will do it. Oh my God, this person wants me on their night show. Let's go.
Yeah, exactly.
But now, like, I'm pretty sure everybody in the room is from the area, right? Mm-hmm. So you guys, I don't know. I think you do, but how lucky like a generation has it that you didn't have to go do that. Part of me loved it, but part of me is also like, it was a struggle.
Yeah. Yeah. You know? I mean, it put hair on your chest per se. It really developed thick skin and made you figure stuff out, because I tried it.
Yeah.
But I was in such a predicament at the time where I was on my way to getting married, finishing up Illinois Center for Broadcasting downtown. And they're like, man, Milwaukee, you got to drive to Milwaukee. And it just didn't work out for me at the time, too. But it did add a little bit of excitement to the journey. It did make things more challenging. Mm-hmm. But you're right. Mm-hmm. Things are changing.
Yeah. I think all of us in radio, too, in one form or another. I mean, all the way up to like, you know, Angie Taylor on Rock 95.5, you know, Fred on The Fred Show, even Joe Soto, right? All these iconic voices that you hear.
Yeah.
I think we all are survivors. Like, we've all had to, like, go through some stuff.
Yeah.
There's not a lot of industries where, in like, early on, it sucks and you got to, like, work through it and you stay with it. I'm still going to go on. You think any other job, you're like, screw this, man. I'm just going to go do something else and have that safety net and have that career that I know I can succeed and be safe. And but we're like, we're getting up at 3 a.m. you know, we're driving out to wherever, you know, to do an event,
just
you know,
an event.
So I think like hustlers and survivors are what radio people really are to the core. I feel like
I agree. I say that all the time. Like, I think that, you know, you can try to run away from your dreams, but they're always going to find you. Like, you can always try to leave them alone and be like, I'm just going to do something else because this isn't working or it's taking too long. But that thing that keeps you up at night is always going to keep coming back.
I love
that. You have to listen.
You cannot run away from your dreams. They'll find you.
No, yeah. All the time. Good. Every night, even. It will.
So, you know, we're coming to this industry understanding that, hey, the money's not going to be there. The hours are going to be crazy. Yeah. What they're asking from you will be crazy, right?
Yeah.
And like you said, hey, this sucks. I can go elsewhere. I can do something else that, you know, doesn't require as much. What keeps you going for the person who's ready to give up now?
Yeah. No, I think what it is I've always wanted to be in radio and passion, right? So I'm talking like always, meaning 10 years old, we didn't have much. We didn't have cable. We couldn't afford to go on vacation. We lived in the inner city, a single mom for most of it. So, you know, we had to survive. We had to like figure out a way to entertain ourselves. Mm-hmm. Guess what was free? The radio. So I spent a lot of time, little Brady in his bedroom, listening to, you know, top 40 radio stations growing up and, you know, calling them, requesting songs, like as a little kid.
Yeah.
And then, you know, fast forward in my career and now I have little kids call me. It's right. Weird. But I think that part of it, just I've always wanted to do it. Mm-hmm. And in high school, I knew that's what I wanted to do. In college, I knew I wanted to do it. And there's part of me that was like, you know what? I don't think I'm good enough. I don't think I have the talent. I don't think I have, because, you know, we've all met talent. Some people are natural, right?
Yeah.
I'm not natural at all. I am not a natural radio person. I know that sounds weird, you guys, right?
Like, a little bit.
I'm not. What you see and what you hear now took a long time to get to.
Mm-hmm.
And so there was some doubt early on. And there was a time, there was a crossroads. I remember talking to my mom and I was like, okay, I can either give up on the stream because it doesn't look like it's happening because I need to pay rent, or I can go become like a manager at Olive Garden, right? Like, you know, like like one of these two things has to happen. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, I just took a chance, like I said, and I moved in the middle of Pennsylvania and kind of grinded, and the rest is history. But I think to answer your question, I think it's just I've always wanted to do it. Mm-hmm. And I think that's there's two types of people that do what we do. There's people that knew from like day one, like out of the womb, I got headphones on, mom. Or the people that kind of luckily fell into it, like through whatever their talent is, because a lot of those people are naturals too. But I'm the one that always wanted to do this from day one. So like 10-year-old me going back, if I told them I was here in Chicago, mind blown.
Wow.
Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
And while you were in like the thick of it, because you said it took you a minute, like how did you find like your like voice and your creative like flow?
Yeah. So it took a long time. Like I'm still working on it, I feel like. And I feel like you always need to.
Yeah.
Because, and especially in the format that I work in, top 40 pop music, you know, things are constantly changing like every day. Right. Mm-hmm. So you have to kind of evolve a little bit too. Early on, I was lost. Like I didn't know what my identity was. I borrowed from others, like a little bit from this guy, a little bit from that person, a little bit from that girl, and then kind of made that me. But the more I got comfortable behind the microphone, the more I realized like it's more about like who you are and pull you out who you are.
Yeah.
And be confident in who you are. Who cares what everybody else thinks? And by the way, people are gonna love who you are because you're being genuine. You can hear somebody and be like, that's kind of phony, right? Like the old school radio talk person, right? Like that. Like, for a while I tried to be something that I wasn't. And I think it was a lot of coaching. I've been so lucky to have the best mentors. Like, you know, our boss here is one of like the best at doing that. He's so good at pulling out that, you know, that brand that you have deep inside, because we all have brands personally.
Yeah.
And collectively. And I think that it just takes time. It takes reps. Like I said, like, you know, going on almost 15 years of this, like I'm still figuring it out. You're still trying to try new things. You're still trying to, you know,
right.
I mean, what I do, like what I am now, I have like the core, like I'm Brady. I'm the Mr. Positive, like let's celebrate life. That's me.
Yeah.
But you're always still trying to like tweak it a little bit and, you know, get a little bit of pull, a little bit of this in. But I will say like the greatest people that do what we do, they also have borrowed from other people.
Mm-hmm.
Inspiration, you know? So if you hear something that you love, you know, I'm going to borrow that, like, but make it a Brady version of it.
Right. Make it your own.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you have to, like, you know, just take things as they go. And you have to always, like, be okay with being a student.
Yeah.
Like, no matter how much you know or how many years you have in the game, how much skin you have, there is still so much more to learn from other people. And to, you know, jazz up your show.
Yeah. That's what I did there. No, constructive criticism is important. It's very important because, because, you know, our goal, what we do on the radio is to keep people engaged. We want them to keep listening to our radio station. That is our one goal, or that we want them to come back the next day. Like, okay, this is my routine. This is what I do. So in order to do that, you got to present something that is memorable, that stands out, especially now because there's so many options. There's so many different streaming services. People can get Sabrina Carpenter songs anywhere, but why do they come to Kiss FM? Well, you know, it's because there's a friendly voice on the other side that they can relate to. Maybe they got Taylor Swift tickets. We bribe. No shame.
Oh, yes.
No shame. Yeah. So, it's a fun adventure. And I just love learning about the business and learning like what's next and learning, you know, how to perfect the craft and what the person that's listening to us, what's the reason why they are.
Ooh. Couldn't say
that was a mouthful.
No, that was amazing. Yeah.
I want to know what's like something about this industry that still makes you feel like a little kid. So for me personally, it's the jingle balls. It's the big jams, summer jams, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's meeting someone that I grew up listening to.
Yeah.
That's like top tier for me every time. Mm-hmm. Someone that I saw on TV or, you know, like that's a moment that I'll never trade for anything. Is there a moment that continues to come and you always get the same feeling?
That's a great question. I feel like, because you don't realize you're in the moment until you tell yourself you're in the moment. And we've all done Jingle Balls. We've all done these big concerts and these big events and met so many different celebrities and artists. And when you're in the moment, it is really cool. But it's when after the moment that you stop and you're like, oh my God, like Bruno Mars just talked to me for like 5 minutes, right?
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
that in my wildest dreams, like what? Like what did I deserve to do this and to get to this point? And there's very few people that get to do that ever.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's a great example. I think like this is it's kind of silly one, but like when we brainstorm ideas, like me, my PD and our promotions director, shout out Jason Brown.
JD, what up?
when we have meetings, I can't tell you the amount of times, like in the middle of the meeting, I'll just stop everybody and I'll be like, guys, you know how ridiculous we sound? And this is our job. Like we come up with the stupidest things.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, there's no other industry that pays you to come up with absurd ideas and, you know, and just have like blasphemy happen in a meeting. So I feel like that's part of it too, because that's more of like an immature thing as opposed to a kid thing. But just reminding myself constantly, like, back in the day, I used to be on the other side of the speaker, you know, now I'm talking to somebody on the air and like I'm picturing them like in their car driving, you know, listening to me like I was doing and always wanted to do. You know, you have to remind yourself. It's so tough to do because we're just like, we all have a million things we're doing, right?
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes you just got to like give it like its basic like picture and just like vision this.
Yeah.
10-year-old Brady in the car with his mom. Singing like I don't know, Celine Dion. But I don't know. I was just thinking of something from the 90s.
Love that.
And that's like another 10-year-old with their parent. And you guys know, like when you meet these listeners, they come up to you like you're the celebrity, and you're like, not me. Like, you want to take a picture of me? Like, I want to take a picture with you. But you have to remind yourself about that, you know, because. Otherwise, like, we just go and get into our routine and we forget, you know, why we're here in the first place.
I agree.
Yeah.
So before we get into rapid fire, I have to pause and I have to say something. Mm-hmm. So my 2-year anniversary with Kiss was on Tuesday.
Yep. Big anniversary.
And so, we are a better station because of you.
Oh,
FYI.
Stop.
We are.
Stop.
Flat out.
I agree.
Yep.
Thank you. Because
Brady.
No, for real, Brady, I just want to say thank you, seriously, because it means a lot when somebody sees that you have this dream, you have this passion inside of you, and that you really like believed in me. So thank you. I just want to say that.
Oh, okay, of course. You know, Jazz, honestly, let me tell you from the bottom of my heart, keeping it real, that was one of the easiest decisions I've ever made. When you see and hear talent, you just know. And we're like, okay, can we get you on yesterday? And you've been crushing it and you're so eager to learn. And by the way, sky's the limit for you. Do not think like this is it. Do never think that, because there is a lot inside of you and you guys too, what you guys created here. Don't ever think like this is it, because there's so much more. So much more to come. So I'm very proud of you. 2 years. Thank That's Dubai.
I know.
Jazz's brunch on Sunday. Party. Let's go.
Yeah. I feel like I need a drink now.
Mimosas.
I just had to get that out. So thank you. Because it really does mean a lot to me.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And I'm glad you said this, because she won't take it from myself or Steve when we say the same thing, like, Jazz, you are such a star. She's like, cut it out. But I'm glad it's coming from Brady. I'm glad it's finally being received, because you are a star and we see you. Yeah. We really do.
Yeah, you got to listen. You got to listen more. You got to listen more. The time will be right when you're finally like, you wake up and be like, Jazz.
Little hair flip.
Yes.
Okay.
If I had hair, I would flip it.
I saw the same thing you saw.
Yeah.
That was the main reason why I chose to team up with her a long time ago.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, let's get into rapid fire now. All right. That's enough about
it's therapy hour. I like it. Getting deep.
Yeah.
Real recognizes real.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
The one rule for a rapid fire, Isaiah, please.
Well, we're on a time crunch too, though. Let's be aware of our time.
Okay. Yes.
One rule.
Yeah.
Whatever comes to mind, let it ride.
Yeah. I'm so used to asking these.
Yeah.
So here we go. I'm never on the receiving end.
Who's going to kick it off?
I'll go. Yeah. I'll go.
Beautiful.
Okay. Yep. One food you can't live without.
One food I can't live without, my mom's macaroni salad.
Ooh.
Yep. She makes it the best. And by the way, it's basic ingredients, but she's got the mom love that sprinkles in. It just tastes better.
It's always the mom love for
it
me.
Is.
Always.
Yeah.
Okay. Your very first job ever.
Very first job ever was I was a babysitter for a little girl down the road on Summer Street in Thorndike, Massachusetts.
Wow.
Your memory is amazing.
Yeah, but I don't know what I did yesterday. So don't ask me anything from 30 on. It's everything before that.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Best compliment you've ever gotten.
Best compliment I've ever gotten. Let's see. I probably have to go back to my wedding day, my best man speech.
Wow.
One of the best men would have said, he sees, I forget how he put it. He had a lot of nice things to say, but basically he told me how proud he was of me and how this ride that I'm going on with my wife has just begun. And that really stuck with me. Okay. Yeah, let's go. Uh-huh. And it's going to be a wild one.
Yeah.
And it has been. Yeah.
That's beautiful. Okay. Yes. Last one for me.
Yeah.
Name one guilty pleasure, Brady.
Guilty pleasure. Mm-hmm. Any guilty pleasure.
Any. We've heard them all.
Ooh. Guilty pleasure. I'm going to go. I don't know why Taco Bell just comes up. Taco Bell is the first thing, because I could just go for that any time of the day.
Taco Bell. We love a good Taco Bell.
Yeah.
It's so say 3 a.m.
It's so the one of the lesser of the healthy things to eat. Mm-hmm. But I don't know why. It's just I had a bad day. Let's get some Taco Bell.
All right. What's your go-to? Because mine is the Doritos Locos.
Doritos Locos is good. Mm-hmm. If I'm just doing one thing, I'll probably go Crunchwrap Supreme. Because you get a little bit of everything. Yeah. And by a little bit, I mean a lot.
Yes.
It's value.
Yeah.
It's a lot for a little. Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see. Yeah. What's your go-to karaoke song?
Go-to karaoke song. So if I have somebody with me, we'll do Regulator.
Ooh.
So I'll be Warren G and my buddy will be Nate Dogg.
Okay.
Nice.
Yeah. Otherwise, you want to get the crowd singing a lot, right? So I'm probably going to go Blink 182, All the Small Things.
Okay.
Everybody say it ain't so,
All right.
Nice. Yeah.
What's food you can't live without?
Food I cannot live without.
Oh, you said that already? Oh, God. I'm just doing that right here.
That's right.
All right, let's
see. Mama's macaroni salad.
Mama's macaroni salad.
Yeah, that'll be number one. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Shout out Tamarind.
What's your most used emoji?
My most used emoji? I'll tell you right now. Let's look. I'll bet you it's the laughing face. Let's see here. Let's see. Yeah, laughy face. Followed by arrow down, because we're always posting, click here.
Okay.
And then fire emoji, because we're always posting.
Got to.
Yes.
Got to,
yeah. We're always posting. Yeah.
Best pizza in Chicago.
Best pizza in Chicago, Michael's Pizzeria on Broadway. It's tavern style. I usually get the, we usually get sausage, peppers and onions. Although I love mushrooms, my wife is highly allergic, so sometimes I'll get my own pizza.
Real?
Yep.
Gotta look out.
Have
for
you guys
the wife.
Had Michael's before?
No, we haven't.
Oh, the sauce is like, it's got like, it almost tastes, it sounds weird, it almost tastes like cinnamon, like a little, like a weird, like, so like sweet. It's a sweet sauce.
Okay. Yeah.
I like sweet sauce.
It's really good. Yeah, Michael's is really good.
This will be the last one for me, and then you can take it away, Steve. Yeah.
Got it.
Let's see. One celebrity you can hang out with for today, who would it be?
That, you know, there's a lot that I've met and have been lucky enough to hang with, not for the day, but like, you know, you get your meet and greets and, right. and sometimes you get a little extra time. I'm gonna go Ed Sheeran. Ooh, Ed Sheeran was my guy. Like, he always has been so real. Mm-hmm. Like, a lot of artists, you know, these are millionaires. They have a billion things going on in their lives. He's always like looked at you in the eyes and like asked questions about you. And you know, he's just a genuine dude. Plus, like, I feel like you could go grab a beer with him at, you know, at a pub downtown and just have a good time. So I'm gonna say Ed.
Nice.
Yeah.
I like that answer.
Yeah. Say Ed.
Good choice.
That's what's up. Now, I did leave briefly, so if I repeat a question, let me know.
I'm out. How dare you? There's no repeating.
I didn't leave.
A Midday live show.
Awesome. All right. We got this. Dogs or cats?
Oh, okay. So
here we go.
So you, old me used to be dog.
Okay.
And then met Rachel, and she is a cat person. So I'm like, okay, cool. Let's like, you know, compromise. So we'll get one dog, one cat.
Yeah.
That's not how it works, Steve.
No.
we have two cats. That was our compromise.
That's your
anyways, now cat. I never thought I'd be a cat guy. I'm the best cat dad ever.
Aww.
Yeah. You just leave him alone. Just leave him alone.
Oh no, bro. You gotta have your good. You gotta have a good cat time.
Good. Oh, yeah. Like petting and all loving them, talking to them.
Petting and Jude, man. They're characters.
So you're definitely a cat guy.
Now I am. Yeah. Yeah. Proud to say. I was converted. I was converted.
What's your most prized possession, Brady?
My most prized possession?
Yeah.
Oh, geez. Not a very materialistic person. The first thing that pops into my head is I have a plate that has, it's a gold plate, like it's an Egyptian hieroglyphic plate.
Oh.
And apparently, as lore may have it, at least this is what I was told growing up, who knows what, you know, things are kind of exaggerated as you're younger. It came from Egypt, and my family, who I know very little about, from Lebanon, the country, have another two plates that are similar, and the three plates like kind of tell a story. Wow. So that's hanging on my wall, and that's the first thing that popped in my head.
It's amazing.
Yeah, I don't know. It's probably not worth anything, but it just looks cool.
Wow.
Yeah,
that's nice.
It looks like an artifact.
It probably is.
Brady's Museum. You
know? I would say that, or I would say probably my collection of old air checks.
Oh my
God. Nice.
Yeah. Old cassette tape air checks for people.
We're talking like cassette tape, hold, record and play and pause. And
Yeah. So for people that are watching that don't know what that is, so like cassettes you used to put into your stereo and hit play. And then when you're in radio and you're coming up, you want to like record your voice. Mm-hmm. So you record them on cassettes and then you'd hand it off to your boss and your boss would like critique you. We've all had those. And then I have a box full of those. I haven't listened to them in 10 years.
Wow.
But one day I'm going to pull them out.
That's amazing.
There you go. Make it a throwback Thursday.
One. Yeah.
I love that.
Yeah.
Final question. Yeah. I know you're hard on time. So
I'm good.
If you could name one thing you wish you were better at, what would that be?
One thing I wish I was better at.
Yeah.
Professionally, I wish that I had like the crazy TikTok editing skills that everybody's got.
Yeah, amazing. Yeah.
And another thing I wish that I was better at was, that's a great question. Trying to make more time for family.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Same.
Yeah.
Same.
It's tough.
It is.
It's tough. And by the way, I have a great family and they understand my time is limited.
Yeah.
And I feel guilty that they accept it. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Every time.
Yeah. They're like, I'm sorry. I'm calling you. And I'm like, don't be sorry. You're calling me. Like, I know you're busy. I'm like, I don't care. Like, you know, and especially because they live so far away.
Yeah.
They all live on the East Coast. So,
oh man.
So that's probably the other thing.
Thank you so much, Brady.
Thank you guys.
No, thank you.
Amazing interview.
Bring me back, man. This is fun.
We have to.
All right, cool.
We will.
More to come.
Yes.
As you said.
I love
more
it.
To come.
Appreciate
and
it.
And next
guys.
Time you come back, yeah. we'll be even higher and we'll have even mm-hmm. more stickers and more banners.
Guys, we're gonna be in space. We're gonna be in outer space.
We could. We could. We could, maybe.
Period. Make sure you guys follow him at Brady_radio, okay? Thank you. Midday Live Show is coming right back. Don't go anywhere. Hey, it's the Midday Live Show. We are back in action, live from iHeartRadio Chicago. Yes, camera woman. Hello. Hello, queen. Okay, so we're back with Steve Styles, DJ Spoil Milk.
What up,
and
what up?
Right here, Jazz, Jazzer Fierce. And our next guest is here in studio. You know him from Chicago PD. You've seen him you've seen him everywhere, you know. And he is a local actor. He's from Chicago. And he also is dabbling into music now. Got a new song called Over the Edge. It's out right now. So please join me in welcoming Brandon Weathers to the Midday Live Show.
Hey, now. Thank you.
Of course. Sure. How you feeling?
Feel good, man. It's a pleasure to be here. Really appreciate you guys for real. So I'm excited to see what happens.
I love the excitement. Oh, yeah. I love that.
But also a cautious. He's like, I'm excited to see what happens.
I'm excited to see what happens. Ready for it.
Yeah.
He's like, we're going to come up with answers for whatever's thrown at us. We'll see what happens.
You're going to have something for sure.
Okay, yeah. Well, a good way to transition. You know, we got a brand new guest in studio, same episode. I'd like to bring up our mission statement once again, too. A friendly reminder to everybody who pays attention to the Midday Live Show. Our mission statement is to enrich, to educate, and to entertain our audience, to reflect the diversity of the local and world community, Chicago, and to provide a channel for individuals, groups, issues, and music that have been overlooked or underrepresented by other media.
You killed it.
Oh my God.
He killed it. That word. Because he always.
You want to take the vision, Jazz?
Yes. That's what Raven says. To become the most creative media company in the world through data-driven decision-making, collaborations, we are heavy on that here, and communicating with the community.
And we got to make sure that we, you know, talk about the culture real quick.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We got to make sure we respect each other through celebrating our diversity. Mm-hmm. So everyone can do their best and remain honest and impartial.
Boom.
Exactly.
Yes, sir.
Well, thank you, guys. Thank you, Brandon, for coming this way.
Thank you.
How was traffic today?
So honestly, traffic wasn't bad. I'm from Bolingbrook. So
are you from Bolingbrook?
Yeah.
Bolingbrook.
You took 55?
Yeah, I did.
You see that car accident?
I did. So
he's like, we can relate.
I'm confused.
He's fuming.
So here's why it wasn't bad. So I had put my GPS in, and at first it said like an hour and like 12 minutes. I'm like, why is it taking so long? And then, like, you know how like Apple like changed and like give like a faster route?
Yeah.
It said take like this frontage road. So I'm just following it. I have no idea where I'm at. And I see like the highway is like
parallel,
like stopped.
Oh,
so I seen like there was a couple ambulances and stuff. And I seen like there's one car.
Mm-mm.
I ain't paid too much attention, but like there was no traffic behind me on the highway for like 10 minutes because it was like legit stopped.
Right there. It was blocked off.
Wow.
I had never seen something like that before.
Yeah. So I'm from Joliet.
Okay.
Yeah.
Joliet. Yeah.
And I'm like, what is going on?
I was so confused.
Right. I didn't even see the actual accident.
Okay.
I had to take another way too. Mm-hmm. But I use Google Maps, so it's telling me like there's an accident from here to here. Mm-hmm. You need to get off the expressway beforehand. And I'm like, bro, well, I'm stuck because I got nowhere to go until I can get to
an exit.
What was that? 355.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I'm like, bro, it's cooked. It's over with. Mm-hmm.
Well, tell us a little bit about Bolingbrook. You know, what makes Bolingbrook Bolingbrook? Is that your stomping grounds? Have you always been in Bolingbrook?
I'm from Lombard originally.
Okay.
Okay.
I moved to Bolingbrook when it was still sort of like developing into like a newer suburb. Mm-hmm. It's been around for a couple of decades, but like it was like no one like stayed in Bolingbrook for real. So came out here in 2003, and that's where I've been since 2003, Bolingbrook. So
nice.
Like most of my family's like in Chicago, like around Chicago. So like I'm familiar with like the area like a lot plus. So Bolingbrook, man.
Bolingbrook.
Hey, Bolingbrook's a crazy town.
Yeah.
Really?
Boughton Road, right?
Boughton's
crazy.
I used to
they used to mess with me. I used to have a friend that go out there, but no, it's pronounced Bouton. Bouton. They just mess with me. That's all too. But wild times out there. Galaxy Club.
I don't even know.
They shut it down.
Okay, that's why.
Yeah, but it's 2003, 2004. Good times.
I don't know.
It's crazy.
Yeah, I've heard of that too.
Galaxy Club. I'm trying to think. I don't think I know what Galaxy Club is.
I don't know that one.
It's been going on for a minute. Yeah.
Really?
That's some old people
Steve
stuff.
Is 38.
Oh, okay. That's some people stuff. That's some people stuff.
Steve told us that he was 38. We still.
Yeah. 48. 48.
Oh. 48.
Oh. 48. Oh. 48. Oh, okay.
Looking good for 48.
Here we go.
Damn.
Okay, anyway, back to Brandon. So can you like tell us a little bit about like your acting journey? Mm-hmm. Like how did it first start? And how did you even know like that's what you wanted to like get into?
See, I didn't know. That's what I was trying to get into.
Yeah.
So acting came about. So I had always enjoyed like performing
mm-hmm.
or like entertaining, but that always kind of reflected on sports. You know, like play sports was always basketball like growing up.
Yeah.
So acting like brought to mind movies. Like we get to be all the big action, but I've never seen myself that time of camera like acting. So I played sports middle school, high school, college, and I was lucky enough during the COVID year to play a half season of like independent professional baseball. I'll be a JS. So but that was like a short season because of COVID and all that fun stuff. So that was shut down probably 2 months in, so it wasn't much. After that, I was like, you know, there's like a very small chance I can take it somewhere higher, like the MLB. So I was like, let's just shelf it right now. So like, I still do it on the side, but I was like, nah, let's try and find like a new path to go down, basically.
Nice.
Fast forward a year. So I ain't do nothing for like from like August 2020 to like the following summer. I did nothing. I was just at my little sales job working that, making money that way. And I hate myself for this, but I was watching a movie and I forgot what movie it was, but I was like, I could probably do that. So then I started Googling like acting classes near me, because mind you, no one in my family was an actor, so I couldn't be like, you know, where should I go for acting?
Mm-hmm.
So I Googled it, and then a couple places popped up. The first company said that I had missed the semester, so I had to wait till like another year. I'm like, I don't got time to wait.
Like, I want to do it now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then Acting Studio Chicago, shout out to them. That's who I trained with since fall 2021.
Cool.
They told me the last class was starting in like 2 days. I'm like, I don't know if I'm ready yet. Two days. I'm like, I'll sign up. So I signed up, and then yeah, so fall 2021 is like my official like launch to like acting. So
nice.
Yeah, it was kind of like out of the blue, but
here you
sometimes,
are.
Sometimes you got to do that. Yeah.
Right.
Say sometimes I think that the timing of things are never going to be what we want or right. what we mm-hmm. think it should be, or mm-hmm. like I think I'm ready for real right now, but mm-hmm. sometimes if an opportunity pops up 2 days later, you know, you got to start. You just got to start.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Because mm-hmm. that passion, that dream,
mm-hmm.
yeah. mm-hmm.
turn into a career.
It's gonna drive. Absolutely. It's gonna
yeah.
drive the whip.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
You just in the passenger seat.
Mm-hmm.
And you find you just look up and now you're. You're here
on the Midday Live Show.
On the Midday Live Show. Okay.
Hey, you know. Hey, you know.
Yeah, like for example, earlier, you know, we had Brady on just now, and yeah, he the conversation that we had, he was like, "Okay, so we're gonna put you on the station, right?" Mm-hmm. And this was, I believe, a Wednesday, and I had to be on air on Saturday.
Ooh. Wow.
Yeah, and I was like, "Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
In my head, I'm like." I don't know if I'm ready. I don't, you know, I don't know how to do it. Wait, I don't know. But I had to get it together and I had to figure it out. Like, if you want it, you're going to figure it out.
Gotta go.
And that's it. Because your dream's not going to wait.
That situation reminds me of the word eustress. Are you guys familiar with the word eustress?
No.
It's the word stress with just E-U before it. You can Google it right now if you don't believe me. But eustress is a positive stress, a stress that lights a fire in your belly, a stress that can motivate you to step up your game in that situation. Yeah.
Mm. That's how it felt.
Like almost fight or flight, but not really that much adrenaline. It's more like, I'm stressed out. I have to make a deadline.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
right?
Okay.
You stress.
Like college, 11:59.
Oh, yeah, right? I got to. And then you get bad internet, and you can't upload, and the teacher's like, you suck.
11:59:59.
Yeah, right. That last second.
My greatest papers at 11:50.
Yeah, absolutely.
See?
Yeah.
See? You're Ooh. Just each giving me an example to show how amazing we all are individually.
Absolutely.
Wow.
Nice.
Look at that.
So tell us about your process and maybe what it felt like to get the call like, hey, this is Chicago PD. Hey, this is the shot. Like,
right.
What was that like?
So it's weird. Like, so going back to like that fall 2021, I had finished my first acting class, and then my first teacher was like, you know, that's like your first official, like not credit, but like your first like thing that you could possibly put in like a resume.
Mm-hmm.
And then he was like, you know, go out there, like start submitting to like the local Chicago agencies. Mm-hmm. So I heard that. I was like, all right, bet. So like that night I went home and submitted to every Chicago agency I could think of
mm-hmm.
or find every manager. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. I'm like, I'm gonna take it a step further. Like, I'm gonna like hit up LA, Atlanta, just like see who would say something.
Yeah.
So that night, I probably sent off like at least 80 plus emails.
Amazing. To,
like, agencies, managers.
Hold on real quick. Break it down for those who are listening. What's inside that email? Are there, you know, headshots? Mm-hmm. Do you have scenes that you acted out?
So just copy and paste in, or you're typing up each one individually?
So I would try to make each one personalized so that they can at least like feel like the it was like genuine, like that regard.
Very nice.
At that time I only had two headshots, and I had just that one acting class. It was called Intro to Acting too, so like it didn't look the best, but I was like, I don't have time to wait. Like,
shooter's gonna shoot.
Yeah. So
I'd like to
in the email had like the headshot, the resume. They call it a cover letter, which is why you're submitting to that agency or manager, and like why you'd be like a good fit for them, essentially.
Yeah. That's a lot of typing.
Yeah, at the time, I didn't have a lot that I could like pitch myself with. I was like just saying basic stuff like, you know, I've been taking this class. I'm looking forward to taking more classes, getting new headshots, doing demo scenes, just stuff like that, essentially. Out of those 80 plus, only two responded.
Nice. What'd they say?
The one person said, we can't offer you a spot right now.
Okay.
That was the first one that got sent. I was like, I kind of assumed like no one was going to respond because but then I got fortunate enough, and then my agent to this day, she responded like 2 weeks later and said, can you submit like a commercial audition for like a representation?
Yeah.
So I did that, didn't hear back for a week. I'm like, oh, back to the drawing board.
Right.
I struck out again.
Oh.
And then I was at work on my lunch break, and then I got an email saying, we'd like to offer you a spot in our men's division. I was like, oh, hey. Snap.
Look at that. It's a moment.
I was like,
congrats.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I thought like that was going to be the part where I, you know, I'm gonna start booking nonstop. Yeah. No. That was like December 2021. I was auditioning all of 2022, did not book a single thing.
Oh my goodness.
Probably had like 20 auditions. At that point, I'm like, yeah, this is not for me. Mm-hmm. Cause like, I was so new to the industry. I didn't know like just getting the audition was a win.
Yeah, that's true.
And then casting directors, when they send you an audition, they want you to be like right for the role. Mm-hmm. I didn't get that back then. So I was letting my mind get to me. Mm-hmm. And then I was finally able to break through in January of last year, which is when I booked The Shy first.
Yes.
The Shy, yeah.
Brought it back
that's
home.
Amazing.
Yeah, and that was crazy. I was at home. Cause how it works is like, there's things called like check avails. Okay. Being pinned. So what that means is like, you don't have the role officially yet, but
yeah,
it's down to like you and maybe one other person, you and three people.
Oh, like cuts.
Yeah,
like
cuts yeah,
when they're doing
exactly,
cuts in sports, right?
So it probably goes down from like hundreds of auditions to like five to three to the last two.
Yeah, man, that's gotta tough. Make the heart jump, right?
You know, it's crazy.
By nails.
Yeah, so.
Bad habit.
Yeah, and most of the time, when you are on check avail, like sometimes like they won't even tell you that like you didn't get the part.
Oh, that's some bullshit.
You'll just see it.
You'll just see like they just moved on.
Yeah,
right.
Like,
bye, oh, bitch.
It'll be like 4 months later and you're like, yeah, I probably didn't get it. Like, yeah. Yeah.
That's amazing. Yeah.
So check avails can last, you know, 30 minutes. Like my PD check avail was like 30 minutes. So that was cool. But The Shy was a couple of days. Some people are on check avail for months.
Oh my gosh. Mm.
Wow.
So how did you, I know you asked this earlier, like how did, with all these like no's or not even no's, but just like no responses, mm-hmm. you're like, okay, what do I do right now? Like, how did you feel like you could keep going and you wanted to keep like applying and submitting?
I think with like passion, there's a fine line between like passion and like insanity where like you have to be somewhat crazy in your faith that you mm-hmm. could do something. So I was like, I'm gonna get told 100 times. Mm-hmm. The 101st time they might say yes.
Yeah.
And that's all it takes. And like with acting or music, like all it takes is the one
keep you going, man.
To keep it going, exactly.
Yeah.
So that's what drives me, just my insane desire to win, basically.
Don't say yeah. insane. We'll just say
no, you're right. Yeah. You're right.
You gotta be delusional. You gotta be delusional. You gotta be delusional. I'm delusional for sure. Yeah.
So it's like for me, I wanna know when you have a role, right? Mm-hmm. Is there a way for you to shut it off? Or when you're in a role, you're so insane, you know, this is who you are for the next 2 weeks. Like, right, you know, right. I'm walking in the house just with the chip on my shoulder because I'm playing a guy who has a chip on his shoulder type right. thing.
No, so with that, I can always turn it off because like with these roles right now, they're called co-star roles for the most part. Mm. So it's like shorter dialogue and that kind of thing. So I can immerse myself like when I'm on set in the moment, but it's easy to turn off with something like that because it's not like a crazy like you know, a deep character dive.
Mm.
It's yeah. more to like help like the story progress, so I know like I know my role as far as like making the story progress, so
okay. mm-hmm.
I can easily like turn it off and that kind of thing.
Incredible. Mm-hmm. That's tough because yeah. I knew acting was not for me because I remember when I did a few plays and mm-hmm. the musicals and stuff and in high school I went method. I committed. Oh, okay. I started acting like the like the character outside of school.
Yeah,
so
really?
Yeah, that's a little extreme.
Example.
People do it though.
No, people do it.
Yeah, so there was the Music Man musical. I was the barbershop quartet captain.
Stop.
So a couple days, you know, throughout the week of school, I'd show up with a it's an enharmonic tuner, you know, a portable tuner.
Mm.
You know where you could play that. And then I'd try to get the guys together and I'd make them sing in the hallways. I'd stop them. They'd be like, yo, I got to go to math. They'd be like, get out of here.
Yeah.
My mom, he's just floating the hallways like an idiot. Yeah, delusional. Hilarious. Could never do that.
Right.
The fact that you have that switch, it shows that you're dedicated, you practice, and you're putting in your reps.
Thank you, most definitely.
How does sports help you now that you're an actor?
That's a great question. So the sports, so like, with sports, there's like a bunch of practices leading up to like the games or whatever.
Yeah.
With acting, your classes are your practice.
Yeah.
So if you aren't mm-hmm. taking classes, you're just trying to go out into a baseball game or a football game and be Tom Brady or, you know, an MLB like all-star pitcher or something like that.
Yeah.
Just off pure talent. Wow. Some people have pure talent like that. Most don't, but it's something that can be worked on, which is why classes equate to athletic practices.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, right. You got a formula.
Yeah.
And it's working out well, very well.
Yeah. I mean, Dre was just saying that too last week. Like the classes, you got to practice. Yeah.
That was the number one thing he stood on. He was like, anything, if you do anything else,
that's right.
Take your classes.
Take your classes.
What's something that you want to do next? Like, if you had wanted to work with anyone or on any type of project, what would it be?
Locally, and I'll start with like Chicago first. So definitely Power.
Yeah.
Power
yeah.
for sure. And then The Bear.
They're
crushing like awards season. The mm-hmm. Bear, such a good show. It's written perfectly and the acting is amazing. So, and like that environment just looks insane to be in. Like, I love Insanity. So
you'd be surprised who's listening to the show right now.
Oh no,
I'm so, be surprised.
You'd be surprised. So
they might be like, Brandon, I heard what you said.
That'd be amazing.
Well, thank you so much. Yeah, what kind of advice can you give an up and comer actor who's looking at? You know, I know classes is everything, but is there something else an actor or actress can work on their own independently to prepare them to be better fit as an actor and actress?
Absolutely. So outside of like classes, in the meantime, like classes will like only like allow you to get so far. At some point you got to take it like in your own hands to like, you know, study lines at home or like practice like memorization, because that's big.
Yeah.
A lot of like these new casting directors are saying like you can be on book, which means like in your audition you can like read your script.
No, it's different.
About, like, they don't want to see that.
No.
Yeah,
so
right.
like being off book and memorizing your lines just looks better, looks cleaner. And it like works that memorization muscle in your brain. And you can just, it like allows you to be that much more a character.
Yeah.
And worry less about the actual lines in the paper. So definitely line memorization, working that muscle, and just being consistent. If you're not acting, look up blogs about actors, what's shooting where, who's shooting where, and just get like fully immersed into the actual industry. So you're, like you're just used to it. Almost like a, what's the word I'm looking for? Manifestation process. Like when you immerse yourself in that, it's gonna come to you eventually. So
yeah,
you surround yourself with it.
Didn't Dre mention visionary? Visionary. One must be a visionary. Absolutely. One must vision oneself doing the end goal. That's amazing.
Yeah, and something else you've been working on now is music.
Music.
New, very new for you. How was that transition?
So with, I'm kind of gonna embarrass myself over here, but
it's
so
fine, man.
The music actually came years before acting.
Yeah.
So I consider myself an artist, and I say like air quotes, because the music back then was like, it was like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he wasn't, I didn't know what I was doing. So the first time I ever recorded a song was my senior year of high school. So it was 2015. I went to the library, and me and my friend Omar, shout out Omar.
Yeah.
He was the only person in that school at the time that could like record and like engineer and stuff.
Oh.
So I was like, let's just go to the library and like throw something together.
Nice.
And I don't know if y'all remember, but there was that one rapper from Ohio, Slim Jesus. Y'all remember that?
Yeah, Slim Jesus.
Yeah, like a long, long time ago.
With the drill rap. Yeah, tall. With the white tee.
Yeah.
It kind of sounds familiar. Yeah.
Oh, if you saw a picture, you know who he was right away.
And then, and then they found out, you know, hindsight 2020, we found out more about him.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So the first song I ever did was I remixed that song.
Yes.
Yeah. that will never see the light of day ever.
Oh my god.
You didn't drop it anywhere?
I dropped it on YouTube. But my artist name, it wasn't like my artist name now. And like, I think I was so new to it, I didn't even drop it like a title. Like it might just say like YouTube upload like September 15th, 2015 or something like that.
Drill time. Slim Jesus, drill time.
And then from there I started to like actually put in effort for music and that kind of thing. So
it's incredible.
Yeah.
I love that too. So when you're in the library, just paint a picture, did you guys have to like hush hush and record on the low real quiet with the mic, or did you get a room and able to do some study time, air quotes?
Yeah. So with the library, there was like rooms, and the room was probably like you couldn't even like put your arms all the way out. It was like a little cube box thing.
Perfect.
It was soundproof though.
That's key.
It was soundproof. And they had like the standard like Mac computer. A super, super old like MIDI keyboard.
That's a studio.
And then like two small speakers and a headset. So
it's on.
Yeah. So back then I was like, this is lit.
Yeah.
I'm an artist for real.
Yeah.
And then I've been to actual studios now and I'm like, oh no, this is what it's actually like.
I love that just because I've been there. I did the exact same thing you did. Yeah, but it was different back then. We were on HP laptops, I think. You know what I'm saying? Like, not the Lenovos, you know, but like Hewlett Packards and stuff.
Good times.
See,
good times.
I tried. I was I was logging into my little T-Pain app on my iPhone. On my
I remember that app.
The iPod.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
The voice. The
little, I would pay to hear you rap for sure.
I want to hear that too, actually.
I want to hear that song.
Middle school bars. I had some high school bars too, but.
Yeah.
Yeah, it just wasn't for me either because it was terrible. It was. It was really bad.
Did you, with the auto-tune? Did you know that you were gonna be an artist your whole life, or was there a moment in your life that kind of like solidified the fact that I'm not gonna conform to a 9-to-5 job? Did you have a moment like that?
Yeah, so that moment came for me in I'm gonna say January-ish 2017. Like I said, out of high school, went to college, did like 2 years of college, and then I woke up and I was like, I ain't getting up for class at 8 a.m. Like, I respect everybody that does it, but like me, I just can't do it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I wasn't happy. So I was like, called my parents. I'm like, yeah, I'm coming home. So I left like a week into like that semester. I'm like, I'm coming home.
Oh man.
Like, I'll finish paying back the rest of it.
Yeah.
But I gotta come home. So then I just started researching. And that's when I was still doing music more. At that point, acting wasn't even a thing still.
Oh my gosh.
This is like still way before acting. It was just like the music still.
Wow.
Yeah. So
wow.
Did you always have the name AMW back then?
Nah, so
where did that come from?
I don't know. I was just trying to think of names, and I was like what could be like a catchy name, but like not too like standard or whatever. So I was like, America's Most Wanted. That could be good, like, you know, overseas and like in the like States too. Like I could like do like fun little you know, music concepts with that, album concepts with that. So I was like, okay, AMW, America's Most Wanted. Like, sure, I'll just kind of roll with that.
Yeah. I like nice. It. I like it.
Nice. All right.
So now we got to, we could do rapid fire before we get into the discussion.
Sure.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
We had discussions.
Mm-hmm, we got to talk about it because I watched it.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
I'm proud of you. I really am.
I'm not talking about... what are you talking about? Love is Blind? That's what you thought I meant?
No. I keep hearing about that from Jeremiah.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, talk to Jeremiah about it. Besties. Boom.
Okay, we can talk to Jeremiah.
Boom. I'm talking about Quiet On Set.
I know that's what you're talking about.
Okay.
And I'm also proud of you.
I was going to watch that anyway.
You were?
Yeah. What?
I didn't know.
Am I not Jasmine Ashley Bennett? Come on now.
I know you are, but I just didn't know because, like, you know, every time I bring something to the table, y'all be like, oh, no, I ain't watched it. But I'm going to get to it. I'm going to get to it.
All right.
I'm going to get to it.
Welcome to the Midday Live Show.
There we go.
Boom. Okay. Who wants to start rapid fire?
Of course.
I started last time.
I'd like to dive in.
Do it.
All right. Now, in rapid fire, it's real simple. You know, we got one rule. Say the first thing that comes to your head. All right, Brandon?
I'll try my best.
We're gonna start off nice and slow. I'll give you the easy ones, and I'll let Jazz and DJ Spoiled Milk take you to the promised land.
Ooh, okay.
Okay.
Stay with me. All right, dogs or cats?
Oh, dogs. I'm super allergic to cats.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
That's a quick one.
What's your most prized possession?
This is gonna sound like really crazy, but like my phone, because like that's like my business.
It's not crazy.
Family,
not
all crazy. That. So
that's real.
Definitely my phone.
Yeah, that's love to hear that. Describe your style in one word.
I'm gonna say me.
Me. There you go.
Me. That's try not to
I like it.
Try not to be like not everybody else, but like I try to like just be me.
So genuine, you know. I love to hear that.
Only way.
Now you do create music. How would you describe your music style in one word? Would it also be me?
That's a great way of putting it, but this might be like a hyphenated word, but like genre bending.
Ooh. Out here, pushing to the limits.
Okay, word to Corbin Blue.
We love that, love that.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay, yeah. I was like, nobody's going to get that. Come on, yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nice. Brandon, what's the best compliment you've ever received?
That I smell good. and that one hits home because like I'm super into like colognes and fragrances, so
you do. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
So, like hearing that, just like thank you so much.
I put in the hours.
Yeah. Thank you. Absolutely.
Last one for me. I'm gonna pass it over to Jazz. Okay. Mm-hmm. Can you name us a four-letter word that starts with the letter B?
Say it. You can say it.
Bark.
There you go. Take it away, Jazz.
Nice.
One day somebody gonna fall for it.
They will. I don't know.
Woof.
That's crazy.
Okay, Brandon, name one guilty pleasure. Ooh. Anything.
Okay.
No judgment.
No judgment.
Maybe a little bit.
A little bit of judgment.
It's okay if you like feet. Just let us know. We've had someone say that before on the show.
Yeah.
I like feet.
We've had midgets.
Midgets.
Tickling your own toes.
That's tickling toes.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, we're transparent here.
Okay, okay.
It's a safe place.
Until it's not.
Until it's on iHeart.
I think I have one, actually. Right now, one of my favorite artists is a all-girl K-pop group.
Okay. Oh.
Shout out my sister. She put me on to them. They're called Twice.
Twice.
Yeah, they're pretty fire.
Yeah.
They okay. are,
yeah. Cool.
Right okay. now, I'm a bunch of the music right now I'm playing for sure.
Really?
So yeah.
I'm going to have to check
in
it out.
The car when you drive?
On the way here, I played like 3 songs, not going to lie. Yeah. I had it on shuffle and it kept playing. I was like, let me go to the album real quick.
Yeah. Album, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I'm going to have to check that out.
Oh, you got to. They're lit, yeah.
Awesome.
Hmm. Okay. Name something that never fails to make you laugh.
Say family and friends. Family and friends for sure. There's never a day where I'm not laughing, like checking text messages or just like basic conversation.
Yeah.
Always a pleasure. Always laughing.
That's good. Yeah. When you have entertaining people around you.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Who do you text the most?
I text the most. Honestly, probably like my guys, like my group chats, like my acting group
great
chat.
Answer, great answer.
Good answer, good answer.
probably, yeah, my guys always texting all day about everything, so.
Mm-hmm. Okay, nice. Do you have any strange like food combinations that you like?
Yeah, it's kind of, macaroni and barbucue sauce.
Oh,
no, that's fire.
My
bro.
Son does that.
Really? Yeah,
okay.
Noodles and Company, low key, is the first time I tried that.
Oh, it's like in store somewhere like that?
Yeah. It's macaroni with like grilled chicken and barbecue sauce.
Might go there.
It's low key, it's hidden.
Go there.
Good nah, that's know. It. It's not strange at all.
You said Noodles and Company?
Yeah. That's hidden.
Interesting.
Nah, for real.
Okay.
Nah, for real.
I take your word for it.
I've just been taking like the Sweet Baby Ray's and like.
Yeah,
and like that way. Like, I know,
that's
like,
the type of barbecue sauce they use too.
Oh, yeah.
You're all in.
Yeah, I'm going there.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Yeah. If you had a warning label, what would it say?
Warning label. Dang, that's a good one. A warning label. May sometimes not respond when I'm like working at like at my craft basically. Mm. Or if my schedule gets busy, like I like see a message and, like I forget it's there. So like may take a long time to respond sometimes.
Yeah. That's real.
Don't take it personal.
Yeah. Don't take it personal.
Please don't take it personal. Please don't take it personal.
That's real. Okay. Last one. One thing you wish you were better at?
Singing. Which is why I started taking singing lessons.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. That's you're perfecting your craft. Go.
Yeah, that's been like a big hole in my creativity. Is like I want to do so much more with music and acting, but
yeah, it's not where it should be.
It's not where it should be.
I think that's my answer to that too. I wish I was better at singing.
Yeah,
like I think at one point I had it. Like in fifth grade, I was in a talent show with my friends, so we sang go. "Be Without You," Mary J. Blige.
Oh yeah,
because you know that little "and" part, the head. Yeah, like run. I thought I was killing it. Let me tell you something. But now today, Jasmine, now I would never like unless it's like karaoke. I take it singing lessons and stuff. No, I wouldn't do that. Because I'm not really trying to like be, you know, jazz that's the right. artist, you know. I think that's gone. That left me a that's long time ago. That's gone.
Speaking of karaoke, what's your go-to song?
To be honest, I've never done much karaoke for like that singing reason. But the last time I did do it, it was a Bad Bunny song. I forgot which song it was. It was Mia with Drake.
Oh, okay.
Oh yeah.
Oh, okay. Mia.
That's nice. What I did. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's what I did. They was trying to get me to do like Usher and all that stuff. I'm like, who do y'all think I am?
Come on, Usher.
Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that.
Who do y'all
that.
Think I am right now?
That could, you
Steve,
know,
that's what they
that could warm up the vocals, some Usher.
Voice is about to fall out or something. Usher gonna kill my voice. Oh no.
If you could hang out with a celebrity for the day, who would it be?
Probably Drake.
Drake?
Yeah.
I think he's probably one of my top 5.
Absolutely. He's my favorite rapper for sure.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Same. we got into this whole debate about Drake. We're not going to do it today.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I got time for all that right now.
I got time.
Yeah, man. My shout out to Leon Rodgers. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll go into this debate. Yeah. Damn that, once a week, right?
Yeah.
He's a hip hop head who's like, no, man, real hip hop is with Nas and Wu-Tang and all them. I'm like, that's great.
It's great, yeah. It's great music.
That's good music, right? But for the last decade, if not more, this man has been holding it down.
Yeah.
But no, man, he be sounding soft. He always singing his stuff. I'm like,
that's a good Leon impersonation.
That was good.
I'm like, but you got to understand, and this is just my personal opinion. Drake knows how to make music from every perspective there is. Mm-hmm. And you, as an artist, you got to really, you know, you got to recognize that. And I'm going to just leave it there because I know you guys... You know,
I ain't got nothing to say.
I remember that conversation because
conversation too.
Leon was worried about me. He's like, "You listen to a lot of gangster rap, Steve. You gotta throw a little Drake in there for you." I'm naming like Nipsey Hussle, Dave East.
Oh yeah,
you know, Pusha T. Yeah. He's like, "Chill,
relax.
Get a little aggressive."
Yeah, he thought he was like sticking up stores and banks and stuff.
Yeah.
Drake, yeah, I hang out with him too. Absolutely. You probably have a ball too.
That's what I'm saying. Club. Yeah.
Strip club,
right?
He probably threw a party for the ladies and had a was that one of those claw machines for Chanel bags? That's so you know his bars are gonna be crazy.
Oh yeah,
that's a crazy bag, mm-hmm.
Right? I
would definitely, yeah. All right, Chicago pizza. Mm-hmm. Who has the best?
See, that's a tough one because recently I just had like my first like true deep dish pizza.
Mm.
So
okay, all right,
yeah.
Let's reverse it then. You are living in the suburbs right now. Mm-hmm. You okay?
Yeah.
What's the best suburban pizza? What's your go-to right now? It don't gotta even be the best.
Probably either Rosati's or Home Run Inn.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Nice.
Okay.
Home Run Inn is decent. Yeah. Decent. I rock with Home Run Inn.
Yeah. Other than that, you got like, you know, Pizza Hut, Domino's, but it's like
yeah.
Kind of tough. Who's your inspiration? I like this question. Who inspires you to be you?
Probably my parents. Like, I was fortunate to have, like, both growing up my entire life, so, and they did, like, a great job, like, setting the standard, like, what to expect with life. Mm-hmm. It, like, showed me, like, the ropes, basically, so, mm-hmm. Especially, like, with, like, the music influences, too, like, I grew up, like, in, like, a very diverse house, so my dad's African-American, my mom's white, so her side was more, like, rock, pop, that kind of stuff. His side was more rap, R&B, soul, Motown, all that kind of stuff like that, so, mm-hmm. Which is why, like, I love music so much, because I heard everything.
Everything.
Judas Priest. Metallica, whoa. All the way to like Smokey Robinson,
look at that,
the Vandross, like stuff like that. So Michael Jackson. So I had like that entire range to listen to from the age of 6 to 26. Nice. Right now. So yeah,
nice.
Yeah, shout out.
I like it.
Sure. Yeah, man, that's huge.
Mm-hmm.
Just well rounded. Yeah, I guess we'll go out with a bang. Have you ever had to take one for the team?
This wasn't on the list.
Take one for the team.
Yeah, you ever had to take one for the team? If so, story time.
So I think I know what you mean by this. So I'm gonna just start answering what I think you mean. And if I'm answering wrong, you can just stop me anytime.
All right, bet.
So I was with two of my friends.
Yeah, it sounds like we're going in the right direction.
We'll see.
I was with two of my friends, not gonna say their names. Mm-hmm. But we were at this club in Chicago called Moe's in River North, Moe's Cantina.
Oh, Moe's, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness. So it was three girls at the bar. And then all of us were single and stuff. Mm-hmm. We didn't know if they were, but like, of course, we were like,
gonna three for three, let's go.
Yeah, we're gonna like approach like respectfully. So what happened was there was three at the bar.
Mm-hmm.
Only two knew each other. The other one was just like just sitting there by herself. Mm. So we approached them. One that was by herself got up and walked away. So I was like, oh, that was just two of them. Like this is awkward now. So they walk up, I walk up, and they're like, talking like whatever, and then they're like, we have a third friend. I'm like, oh, cool. Like, okay, this works out fine,
right? And you thinking it's the one that walked away?
Yeah. So they're like, yeah, she's in the bathroom right now, she'll like come back. Okay, they had already like talked to them too, so I'm sitting like, oh, all right, I guess the third one, like I'm gonna talk to the third one.
Yeah,
she come out the bathroom.
be mindful of what you say.
She come out the bathroom. There was nothing wrong with, but she was like 6'1" in heels.
Whoa.
Super tall. Mm-hmm. And then the entire time, so I'm sitting down the entire time, Uh-huh. For some reason, she did not want to sit down. So the entire time we're talking, I'm like, my neck is broke. I'm talking. I'm not going to be ignorant. I'm a nice person. I'm just talking, trying to get to know her.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I'm like, the entire time, I'm like, can you please sit down in my head? Like, this is like hurting. Like, she was tall, man. Oh, so they go off, and then we just end up talking for like probably like an hour or so. And then
yeah,
nothing else came from it, but like, afterwards, I hear him like they come up laughing and stuff. I'm like, I bet. Yeah, okay, cool. Like, y'all lucky, y'all my homies. Cause that's crazy. That's dirty work right there.
Y'all should have caught the vibes and say, all right, we gonna get out of here, y'all. Nice. Bad. But y'all made me sit there.
Yeah, had me talking to Sue Bird from like WNBA and stuff. I'm like,
Sue Bird, right?
How tall are you?
I'm like 5'9" probably.
Okay.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah. So she has some height on me for sure.
Mm-hmm. Well, that will wrap up rapid fire questions.
Yeah, for sure. Shout out to you two friends.
Oh, shout out to my friends. Man. They probably watching right now.
Yeah, good.
I told them to tune in for sure.
Tell them to hit the like button. DJ Spoiled Milk, in the meantime, while we transition out of this, can you give a good check to the Instagram page real quick? See how the Instagram live is doing.
Shout out to everybody that is tuned in on the live. Man, we got a lot of people that tapped in for sure. Oh, real quick, shout out to Nikki Taylor. She was an artist that came onto the show, I think, last month, mm-hmm. maybe.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
She was talking about she loves rapid fire questions. So shout out to Nikki. Much love.
She's yes. She's a Rolling Stone rising artist.
Yeah,
now too.
She's a Rolling Stone.
Mm-hmm. You guys.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah? You did.
Yeah, I had noticed she had mentioned the ukulele or something like that.
Yeah, the ukulele. Yeah. That's right. That's wild. Yeah. Yeah.
She's dope.
Yeah, yeah. That's different. That's tough. Mm-hmm. That's different.
That is. So,
she takes it everywhere. That's pretty cool, too.
Yeah, shout out Nikki.
Cool. Well, speaking of Nikki, we got to get into Nick Elodian.
Oh, mm-hmm. Here we go. Ooh,
it's gotten hot in here.
Yeah.
So the Quiet On Set documentary came out. I think it was the 17th, the original date. So pretty much like this documentary was broken up into four different parts. And it was a few Nickelodeon, like child stars from All That, Drake and Josh, mm-hmm. Zoe 101. Giovanni Samuels was also on it. We had Giovanni on the show late January. So shout out to her as well for being on our show and going on there and telling her story.
Yeah.
Because I'm sure that was not easy for any of them to talk about what they went through. Mm-mm. So I just want to see like whoever has watched, also in the comments, if you watched, just like share some of like your thoughts from it. I'm just happy that they decided to do that. Like whoever the producers were, like, I give you guys a lot of applause for getting them together and even having the idea to do this, because it's like, as a child, I kind of remember like this Dan Schneider stuff coming out.
Oh, man.
But it's like you didn't really like get really into it or like read in depth what was really going on. But you remember something about Dan Schneider wasn't right, mm-hmm. you know, when you were watching these shows. So I remember like the Amanda Show. I watched the Amanda Show nonstop all the time. That was my stuff.
He did that. He did Drake and Josh too.
Yeah. So it's like when you saw like when they pointed these people out, like the first guy, Jason Handy, I didn't mm-hmm. recognize him at first.
Okay.
But then when they showed he was like the guy on the Amanda Show that was just like in a blue shirt, he would just be in the audience. Like you would always see him like in the frame. He never had lines. He never said anything. But when they showed him, I was like, oh my God, I remember who that is. And the fact that he was doing like these terrible things behind the scenes, it's like you can't even imagine what those kids went through. Like all the joy and laughter that they gave us.
Yeah.
And we had no idea mm-hmm. what they were going through. It's terrible. Especially Drake Bell. Especially Drake and Amanda Bynes. Like it was tough watching it. It was tough.
I did not want to watch it mm-hmm. for the longest because I'm like, man, this is a childhood memory that is a positive memory for myself, mm-hmm. you know? I loved Drake and Josh. Like, at one point, I can see the first 10 seconds of the episode, but, oh, this is when so-and-so, I'm starting to recite lines, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I did not want to watch it, but it kind of put me in the same emotional room with the whole R. Kelly situation, right?
Oh,
because also as a child, also as someone who was a fan of music, like you said, I grew up listening to that music in the household when it was time to clean.
Mm-hmm.
And now I have to kind of ruin the image that I have for the cartoons that I used to watch, the TV shows I used to watch, and also room and image for the R&B legend of Chicago.
Yeah,
the
same way.
So it kind of put me in that weird energy, like, ah, here we go again. Yep. Mm-hmm. Don't want to watch it, but kind of have to watch this just to educate myself and to also allow these people to be heard, you know? Mm-hmm. So that's kind of my take on it. It's just, it's unfortunate, for real.
It was a rough watch, for sure. Like, I mean, I know I'm a little dramatic, but honestly, like, a few times when Drake was talking and they show, like, the Amanda Show flashbacks and, you know, Drake and Josh, it was like I felt myself tearing up, like, mm-hmm. as he was talking. Because it was just like, you can't even imagine. Drake was always making you laugh.
Yeah, that's like, why it's so...
But he was going through it.
A lot.
Mm-hmm. Like,
how can you put in words when a child loses their innocence? And it hits even more. You're a parent now, too. Mm-hmm. DJ Spoil Milk, too. Part of the reason why I'm a helicopter parent. I pretty much hound anything my son watches online, too. And, mm-hmm. you know, I got to keep track. But you got to be mindful. It's incredibly sad and bittersweet. Mm-hmm. And these hurt people hurt. And you've seen the thing from Macaulay Culkin on moving forward. A lot of kids get hurt mm-hmm. at this age. And they don't come out, you know, sticking to the straight line or sticking to the script. So I'm just heartbroken. That this is still a thing. And from Dan Schneider to even Jeff Epstein, you know, it's a lot of unveiling. Mm-hmm. 2023 was a year of unveiling, but even more so now, 2024.
I guess I always question, you know, you brought up the parents. Mm-hmm. I question some of the parents too.
Yeah.
Like, you have to. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did you know about this? And if you did, why did you continue to
let it happen?
Yeah,
let this happen.
That's neglect for and abuse.
Money? Was it that serious? You know, and that, like you said, I'm a parent now too, so it hits on a different level. And I'm like, man, Can I cut?
Say what you got to say.
How much money that shit is, you know
yeah, yeah, like, you
not,
should.
Not mine.
Mm-hmm. No,
you got me messed mm-hmm. up.
Yeah,
and don't let me find out it was some, you know, because I'll go to jail with a smile on my face.
Yeah, for real.
Type for real. So. Yeah, it's just an energy that I don't want to even put in my little brain at the moment, because mm-hmm. I don't know how I could allow something like that to happen.
Right.
And then money comes to be a big issue, too.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, remember Britney Spears, too, and what she had going on, mm-hmm. and dad was in control of the finances.
That was insane, too.
A lot of these child stars or child actors, they have parents that are, you know, not so well in the head themselves, and they use their own child to get the paycheck.
Yep.
It's disgusting.
Like, I was doing some more research, like, once, like, this came out, but, like this has been happening for, like, a long, 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 like, long time.
Yeah.
Frankie Lyman, another, like, child artist, like, he was, like, a singer mm-hmm. and stuff. Like, he abused, like, drugs and stuff, like, super, super, super early on in his life. But when you're, like, 11, 10, 12, traveling, like, the country, especially, like, back at that time, too, that was, like, the 50s, so segregation and that kind of stuff was, mm-hmm. like, still going on, too, so... Mm-hmm. The people he was around, he had to grow up that quick, and that's what led to his, you know, untimely death, essentially. But just like the parents are like he had like no base to like kind of counsel him as far as like what to do with that at that age back, you know, in the 50s and stuff. So mm-hmm. it's been happening for like a long time, for sure.
Yeah.
Wow. Unfortunately.
Yeah,
it is unfortunate. And I do hope that we don't have to talk about this for too long, because mm-hmm. it's real deep. It's getting heavy in the room.
It's heavy.
Heavy.
Yeah. So it's like, as I said, I'm really happy that they did it. And I hope that it kind of like inspires some type of change in the mm-hmm. industry, like that does not happen to any more kids or teenagers. And I don't know. I've seen a lot of, I hope Disney does one now. Like, I've seen a lot of people saying that.
Yeah, that's probably going to be the worst one.
I'm sure. Mm-hmm. Actually, I mean, I hope that they do it too. I do hope so. I hope that some people,
it's
you know,
the swamp over there, man.
Yeah. I hope that they come out and they speak up. Too. Yeah. I mean, it's going to ruin some childhoods again, but honestly, it's like that needs to be out. It doesn't need to be under wraps anymore.
It needs to be out.
It's got
to
be brought to the light.
And if I can give anybody out there or you guys here in the room with me, how can you fight against this? Values. You got to have your non-negotiables growing up. Mm-hmm. You have to know that there's a right and there's a wrong. You have to have your own standards, your own values that you develop growing up at home. Maybe your home is unstable. Mm-hmm. You have to learn to develop that with time. Kind of like you, your friends can be your own family. You create your own values.
Yeah, I'm super big on that.
Yeah.
at some point you have to like branch off and like develop your character, your personality, like your values, and kind of separate yourself that way.
Very true.
I'm very big on that. Yeah.
Love to hear that.
I agree.
Leave your comments below. Hit the like button. We're dishing out new videos every Friday here on the Midday Live Show.
Yes.
Happy anniversary, Jazz.
Thank you.
Happy anniversary.
Thank you. Thank you.
So we're talking about kids. We're talking about parenting and all that. I guess we can transition to the next topic. There was a mom that went viral for her tweet on Twitter. And she was basically saying, like, Meg Thee Stallion is coming to Chicago, but my teenage daughter's not going.
Got it.
Right? Mm-hmm. And it went up. Right. There's a debate, like, how could you not allow her to see her favorite artist or who opt the bam in? I want to hear from you guys. Would you allow your teenage daughter or son to go see a Meg Thee Stallion or their favorite rapper or artists? And then what do teenagers do? Like, what type of fun is there for a teenager?
Right.
That's a good question.
Great question. Love to hear from you guys, too. Leave a comment below.
Go for it.
Because the mall isn't as fun anymore.
Oh, absolutely.
We were teenagers.
We used to go to the mall all the time. Yeah. That was the go-to spot. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right?
You know, they got to check IDs and everything. For real.
In the mall?
Yeah.
What?
If you're under
this is Joliet stuff, Jazz. This is just Joliet, like, Joliet stuff.
Where do they do that at?
Relax. Second of all, is that Orland?
Okay.
Orland, yep.
Oh, wow.
Schaumburg.
Ooh,
Schaumburg. Yeah.
Schaumburg.
Oh my gosh,
over that's there by you.
Yeah. That's wild.
Yeah, was Woodfield Mall.
Woodfield.
They
yeah,
got the, they got the mall cops at the front door.
What?
You hear me? At, right over there by Cheesecake Factory.
They do. Yeah. I was just there.
Yeah. West Gulf.
Pipe down with the Joliet.
Ooh, you got triggered.
Oh my goodness.
You got triggered.
Yeah.
The Ridge.
Okay.
The Ridge.
Well,
yeah.
The Ridge probably been doing that for a minute.
The Ridge.
We'll talk about Forest City. Let's move on.
Oh my gosh.
LOL.
That's crazy.
So if you had a child that was a teenager, would you allow them to go see a Meg Thee Stallion? Would you allow them to go see, I guess we were talking about Drake. Mm-hmm. Would you be okay with that?
Yeah. I mean, at that point, like, because let's say, like, for example, like your kids aren't going to always tell you everything that's going on most of the time. So there's no way of me knowing, like, that music could be like their escape, like their peace. As crazy as like the music might be sometimes, like with like the up-tempo beats and stuff, they could find peace through that somehow. So and it's like a social thing. So I would 100% allow them to go there, because and first, like my future kids, like I'll have that trust where like with them going out, like I know like I ain't got to worry about nothing. So I would have them like lined up for like being respectful, positive, that kind of stuff. Like they aren't out there acting crazy. So I could be at peace with that, knowing like they can go to a concert, enjoy the concert for what it's supposed to be enjoyed for, and then come home and or do whatever afterwards. So yeah, I have no problem with it.
I'm just reflecting on my own childhood. I loved music forever, you know what I'm saying? So I've gone to concerts as a young child. I would be okay with parental supervision type thing. I mean, that's what it was for me. I went to a Drake concert. It was Drake, Meek Mill, and Waka Flocka. I never forget it.
Dang.
And that's a lineup.
Man, what?
Who?
I was in eighth grade, you know what I'm saying? Going into a freshman year. It was a summer thing.
Yeah.
And one of the homies was like, yo, my father just bought all of us tickets for my birthday. We gone. And my mom and dad were like, okay, is he going with y'all though? Yeah, he'll be there. Oh yeah, go have fun.
Yeah.
Type thing. Mm-hmm. I think that's
kind of
the situation
nice.
That I would be in. I can also understand why the mom did take that approach with the way that, you know, sexuality is very out there now in days.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what will Meg Thee Stallion have on?
Oh man,
is she gonna have on anything at all? You know.
Oh,
that's exaggerated.
Good point,
but,
good point.
You know what will she have on, and what type of
message is she delivering?
Message is she delivering to my 12-year-old, 13-year-old, 14-year-old daughter? You know what I'm saying?
That is pretty young. I was thinking more like 17, 16 kind of thing, but like 12 and 13 is pretty young.
Yeah.
See, now you make me think.
I don't know. I don't know if that's something that like, kind of tough. Drake and them, they fully clothed. Their music wasn't the best as far as lyrically. You know, they might have been talking about violence or drugs or women.
Yeah.
But then, you know, if you have a daughter at home, are you okay? Are you comfortable with her, you know, receiving the message that's being brought to them. Are you allowing your 12-year-old, 13-year-old to go see Sexy Red when she comes to Lollapalooza?
No.
That's a hard no.
Hard no. Mm-mm.
So is it on a concert?
Yeah. Suit, I'm just saying.
She will. Is it on a concert by concert, artist by artist situation, maybe, or is it an age thing? I know if I had a 14-year-old daughter, hopefully I'd, you know, have like a, like I said before, with the chaperones and stuff, maybe a sibling. You know, if a sibling can go with, they'll look out for each other. If I know a parent's gonna go with them, that's perfectly normal with me. I'm on board with it. But personally, I couldn't. Even though I say you can raise your kids to be as best as they can be, but then they got to deal with the world, right? They're either going to be at peace with themselves and at war with the world, or at war with you and at peace with the world,
right?
You know, so no matter how hard you try, I just have a little bit of doubt. That's my little bit of doubt. I think 15 is a great age, you know, once you just get out there and start, you know, socializing with concerts and adult material too. Mm-hmm. But again, too, I'm the same guy that found out about sex when I was 8 years old. Right?
Yeah.
Interesting.
I think I still like coloring.
Right.
He said, I was tying my shoes.
I think I was still coloring.
Yeah, man. Came across a movie called Showgirls at the time, man. And just
the title of that movie as well.
Eyes open. And I've been in the strip club since. Just kidding.
Not JK.
That's
for real.
But we'd love your opinion. Your opinion, though, really matters, especially from a woman's perspective. How'd you go about it?
Yeah, I agree with pretty much all of the things you guys said. Like, it depends on kind of the concert, the artist. And then I want to make sure that my child is like, okay, I wouldn't just let them go alone or just with their friends. So like you said, like a sibling, maybe it's not going to be me because it's like, mom, you know, you're cripping my style. But somebody like an older friend that I trust, a sibling, a cousin, anything. You just want to make sure that the kid is protected no matter what. And the things that they're seeing at a certain age, like, Sexy Red shouldn't be rapping to 12-year-olds. Like,
No.
But the 12-year-olds are the ones that know every word to her song.
I'm sure they do, but they're not going to be at her concert.
But that's also to the parents. What are the parents exposed to the kids?
Yeah.
You know, my son isn't, he's not really listening to rap. He listens to Dragon Ball Z rap.
Yes.
Okay. Right. You know, he wants rap. Like, there you go. You hear about Goku and all that stuff.
Here's your intro.
Right?
I feel like that's a loaded question. What are parents exposing to their kids, right? Mm-hmm. What he may listen to around you
is different.
This is hypothetical, right?
No, right.
But when he's at school, you know what I'm saying? Everybody on TikTok, his friends are sharing whatever. Like, you know what I'm saying? What's cool to them right now may not be cool at the crib.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I actually just DJed a little girl's birthday party 2 weeks ago, I believe.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And the parents like, she loves this song, and they're giving songs like these YouTube kiddie songs.
Okay, cool.
I'm like, this is cool. I got you. I'm about to get you with the Gracie Corner real quick.
Kids bop, right? Kids bop.
I'm here.
The mix is here.
Right. I'm playing that. I literally saw the reaction. She rolled her eyes, looked at her friends,
then
discreetly came around and told me not to play that music no more.
That's crazy.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying?
What do you do? What do you do in that situation as a DJ?
I mean, as a DJ, I'm like, all right, back scratch.
Yeah.
You want to hear this? I got you. You know what I'm saying?
Right? Oh, my gosh.
I'll do the best I can with my materials, with my cards in my hand. Mm-hmm. I'll do the best I can. But, you know, hey, the little Gracie Corner at the crib is great. But when she with her friends, she want to hear Sexy Red. She
got it.
Stallion.
So true. So true. Yeah. So what can we agree on? Prepare them, right? Hope for the best, prepare for the worst. Prepare and protect.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Can we get this deep on the Midday Live Show? Yes, we can.
Always.
And if you guys like this type of content, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe. We're dishing out new videos every Friday. And of course, follow us and subscribe on our brand new YouTube channel.
Yes.
The Midday Live Show channel.
Yes. And what's your Instagram?
Oh, it's real easy, guys. Steve Styles Radio.
Boom.
Pretty easy, right?
How about you?
I mean, it's at the Brandon Weathers.
Brandon Weathers.
Again.
Anything.
Great. Very simple.
Right,
easy.
Pretty simple. Yeah, right to it. Anything coming up in the future that you want your people to know about?
Yeah, for sure. So right now I'm working on like a new EP. Well, my first EP. Mm-hmm. I had never made like a full body work. I had always dropped singles and stuff.
Wow.
But now I'm like, now it's time to like give like a decent amount of body of work. So I'm working like a 4 or 5 song EP.
Nice.
A date for that coming soon, probably. I'm still like working out stuff. Like me, like I'm a perfectionist, and if I like, I listen like in the studio, I'll put like the song so loud, like I can hear if I like breathe right here, or if like I like hit the mic, like I'll hear all that. So I'm like, nope, I'll do it again. So
yeah,
one song might take me
months.
Sometimes like a couple of weeks, like just to get like how I wanted to. So,
but it's okay. Yeah. I think there's nothing wrong with that. You want to give out the best version of yourself.
Quality.
Artistry.
Artistry. Yeah, I like that.
Yeah. Shout out my engineers too. They definitely do a lot. Yeah, because I'm there sometimes for a decent amount of hours, and we definitely lock in and get it done though. But
it's great, man.
Yeah.
There you go, man. Tap in with him. Tap in. He say he's gonna drop something soon. Just you gotta tap in so you know when it's dropping.
Absolutely. Follow that Instagram. Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. You can follow myself at DJ Spoiled Milk as well. The nastiest DJ in Chicago. Oh, real quick. I'm outside on Sunday. I got a brunch coming up on Sunday. All 90s, all 2000s in the South Suburbs at the Chug-a-Lug over there in Glenwood off Halsted, for real.
That's what's up.
I also got one more event next weekend. It's going to be a pop-up shop. It's going to be for adults, where adults can be kids again. So,
That sounds fun.
What's really cool is what I'll be doing is I'll be taking, and hopefully it still hits the same, but I'll be taking our Disney Channel TV shows and our Nickelodeon TV shows, and I'll be mixing that into my music.
That's incredible.
That's a party.
That's incredible.
Hopefully it still hits. You know, I hope I don't hit any, you know, sore.
All right.
Sore songs. You know,
you should Drake probably.
Josh was one of my intros for real.
No, for real.
You should probably print out your Serato report after that.
Oh, yeah.
You should probably submit it.
Yeah.
Because that could be a thing, man. That can be a thing.
It should be cool, man. It's called Candyland. So adults come through to the Candyland pop up shop. There will be food, vendors. There's also going to be adult toys there.
Hey.
All right, now.
Interesting.
Okay.
So you took the words right out of my mouth.
Interesting.
It's going
to
be
spicy.
Yeah.
Okay.
And how about yourself, Jazz? Where can everybody follow you, reach you, and listen to you this weekend?
Yeah, Instagram at Jazz or Sophia's. I will be on 103.5 Kiss FM Sunday for brunch, Brunch with Jazz, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. So if you're not in Chicago, download the free iHeartRadio app and just type in 103.5 Kiss FM Chicago.
Nice.
Absolutely.
Been a pleasure, guys. Episode 17 is in the books.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. It's done. That's a wrap. We're over and out.
Been a pleasure.
Be safe.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you, sir.
We out.